Ladies and gentlemen, we are delighted and honored to welcome Professor Einhoder from Stanford University for a seminar as part of the celebrations of 150th anniversary of Boğaziçi University. Today, Professor Hodder will make his presentation on involving stakeholders in the archaeological project at Çatalhöyük.
Thank you very much for the introduction, and I'm very grateful for the invitation to come and talk to you here in this very beautiful and very distinguished university. Çatalhöyük was found in the 1950s by James Mellart, who excavated it between 1961 and 1965. And it was immediately a site of great interest because it has some strange characteristics. One is that people did not use streets to walk through Çatalhöyük. They walked around on the roofs. Characteristic of Çatalhöyük is that as well as the very rich symbolism and ritual inside the houses, there is also a burial beneath the floors of the houses, so that you can have over 60 people buried within one house. This is a global community that comes together really around this particular image from Çatalhöyük, which I'm sure you all know well, is often called the Mother Goddess. It appears to show a woman in a very powerful position with her hands on the backs or on the heads of wild animals. We have visits to the site from goddess communities. They want to do a range of things such as dance and pray and carry out various rituals. There are some definite female figurines, although this is not clearly one of them in my view, because the breasts are not shown. But I think many people would argue that this is a female, although I've seen many men that look rather similar. In fact, I was sitting by one in the plane on the way over here. The archaeological evidence provides a lot of information about the role of women in relation to men and children at Çatalhöyük. If you look at the chemical makeup of the bones of the men and women, you find that men and women have identical chemical makeup in their bones, which suggests that they have very similar diets. In most societies, men and women have very different diets because they live in very different social spheres.
Why people left the place? I mean, I'm always wondering why people will leave a very flourishing settlement and then they leave due to various reasons. Is there any indication of what happened?
There's nothing like climatic change or disease, although you may be aware of something called the 8.2K event, which is supposed to be a climatic fluctuation at 6,200 BC. And so that's approximately the time of Çatalhöyük. But the trouble is, Çatalhöyük then continues onto the West Mound, and so there isn't really a break.
How come that, let's say, Göbekli Tepe, which is so many thousand years before this, is only a site of worship and no habitation, as far as I know, maybe I don't know correctly. And then Çatalhöyük is just a place of habitation and no public place of worship.
People used to think that the origins of agriculture were associated with the origins of village life. But now there's a new picture emerging, which is that the early agriculture is not associated with villages. It's associated with public, ceremonial, and communal consumption of food.
What are your plans for the sustainability of all this work in the longer term?
The plans for the future are very much up to the ministry and how they want to deal with the longer term. And I have been in dialogue with them now for about a year about how they would like that to happen, and it's still not clear to me what they want to happen, whether they want a foreign project to come back, which I'm sure would be very easy. I've suggested someone, there is someone who's Turkish who would like to take it over, which would be my my ideal would be for that person to take over the project.
We would like to thank you on behalf of Tourism Administration Department and Boğaziçi University for being with us today. Thank you.
Thank you very much.